Good day to everyone. I am Brithanya, a biomedical trainer from Adinapanin Private Limited. Now, in this video, we are going to see the part 2 demonstration of the machine autoclave. In the video, we are going to see its parts, purpose, and its working technique. If you guys missed out the part 1 demonstration video, kindly click the link below given in the description for your reference. So, now let's move on to the video. So now we are going to see the parts of the device autoclave. The brand name of autoclave is Indosurgicals. This is the container where we are going to place our components which are to be sterilized. So it has an outer coating and inner coating of stainless material. So this is the cap of the autoclave. Here you can see there are two valves. So one is stop cock and other one is weight safety valve. So the normal pressure will be attained by the stop cock valve. If there is high pressure which cannot be attained by the stop cock valve, the weight safety valve will be acting to release the pressure in addition to the stop clock to avoid the busting of the autoclaves. So this is the measurement gauge. So in this you can see there are two different units. One is kg per centimeter square or another one is lb per inch square. So here it has to maintain the normal pressure of 15 psi to maximum 20 psi. If it goes beyond 20 psi, we can see red light indication. So if the pressure is lower than 15 psi, we can see the meter measuring in yellow color. These two are the handles used for the purpose of lifting the autoclave as it is a portable form and to open the caps from the chamber. There are two side handles. So at its right side you can see a stream releaser. In addition to two valves, you can use this stream releaser to release the stream from the inner chamber to outer space. Before the initialization process, it is mandatory to lock the stream releaser. Since when the process is going on, the steam will be released from the stream releaser and no pressure will be maintained at normal pressure range. So back side you can see here this is the heating element. Here we are using the heating element like nickel chromium, which is known as nichrome metal. So here I am going to connect my power cord for the AC supply and for the heating process. At the base of the autoclave you can see a metal ring. So this is used to place the autoclave in it. Since the autoclave works under the principle of heating process, if we clip the heated autoclaves in any wooden table or in any plastic table, this will melt the table. To avoid the melting condition, it is recommended to use this metal ring below the autoclaves. Inside the autoclave, you can see this heating element, that is nichrome metal. So the water capacity of the autoclave is about 1 to 1.5 liter. So we have to pour 1 to 1.5 liter in this and we have to place this metal grid inside it like this. So above this metal grid, I am going to place my contents which are to be sterilized. This is the power cord of the autoclave. So here I am going to connect this port in the heating element port. Till this we have seen the parts of the autoclave. Now we are going to demonstrate the working process of the autoclave. Now I am going to connect the power cord to the machine autoclave. So I am going to connect this port in the heating element port. Now I am going to pour the water of about 1 liter. So you can see this can which is having the capacity of 1 liter. So now I am going to pour this water completely into my autoclave machine. Above this metal grid, I am going to place my contents which has to be sterilized. So first, it is mandatory to check whether the steam release is in open or closed condition. So now it is in open condition. So now I have to close this before starting the process. Now I have closed the steam releaser valve. So now I am going to close the cap and turn on the autoclave. So this process takes about the duration for 15 to 20 minutes. I am going to lock this device. You can see the pressure variation in this pressure measuring gauge. So now let's move on to the working process of the autoclave. So as we poured the water of 1 liter inside it, due to the heating of the heating element, that is nichrome, the water will be heated above its normal boiling point. So this water helps to raise the moist air which penetrates into the white cotton cloth which is having the forceps and blades to be sterilized. So this steams kills the microorganism present in the blades, forceps and metal instrument which is kept for the process of sterilization. So after 5 minutes you can see the rise of the pressure range from the initial point 0 to 0.5 ranges. Now it's been 15 minutes, you can see the pressure at 10 psi. Still there are 5 more minutes for the pressure to attain at 15 psi. So it's been 20 minutes, you can see it has achieved normal 15 psi and you can see the steam passing out from the stop clock watch. After attaining the normal pressure, you can see the pressure valve dropping here. So now I am going to open my steam releaser. So this will release the steam from the inner chamber. You can see the pressure dropping here. This is the working process of the device autoclave. I hope this demonstration part of autoclave is helpful for you people to understand more about autoclave parts and its purpose and its working technique. Thank you.